This is how we start these videos now. Kevin Manno about to go over to the Metro and interview the. Let's start that over. Gentlemen, I'm Kevin Manno at the Metro backstage here with Lucero. Hello, gentlemen.
Hello.
How you doing?
I just said gentlemen twice.
Gentlemen.
How are things? How are you feeling?
Good.
Cut. We gotta start. We gotta start over now.
Yeah, we're doing good. Yeah.
I think we're feeling good.
Good.
You guys, you're tight with the Catfish Haven guys, right?
Yeah.
Yes, we are.
Yeah.
You're from Chicago.
Yeah, we've done a bunch of shows with them. We did a tour with them in the American Princess.
Yes.
And then we ran into them at South by Southwest.
Yeah,
good guys.
Yeah, I like them. One thing I noticed actually at South by Southwest, I've seen a thousand Lucero shows, but I noticed while I was there that everyone in the crowd singing along sings in your voice.
Like
I was standing next to this like
my 11-year-old
4-foot tall girl, and she's saying that much further west, and it just doesn't seem natural when she's doing it.
Right,
it's funny. You probably can't hear that from the stage.
No, I can't. I can kind of hear a general. You know,
growl.
Singing, but a general, and that's about it. But folks singing along is a nice compliment.
However they sing.
Yeah, no matter what voice they use. And I've always wanted to ask you, have you ever run into the Spanish pop sensation Lucero?
We've never met her, but there's definitely been some folks that have shown up to our shows thinking it was her.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
It's real funny because you think. She's like the Latin American Madonna, and we're playing some dive bar in San Diego, and they're thinking, they're all dressed up, and you're like, really? Do you think she's going to play this place at all?
She's playing the Casbah? Really?
Yeah.
Really?
150 people? Yeah. It's an intimate show.
Have you ever heard from any of your fans that have gone to see you and they saw her?
I don't think that, no.
Playing a giant arena?
No.
Yeah, they're playing a Coliseum in Brazil.
They're huge in Brazil. Did you just finish the new record?
It's not quite done yet. We got back from South by Southwest, went straight into the studio, worked up until pretty much a few hours before we left on this tour. And we almost got it done, but we got some more vocals and pedal steel.
Well, how long did that take you? How much studio time was involved?
14 days.
Oh, really?
Yeah, 14 straight days from noon to midnight, or noon to 2 a.m., whatever it was. Are you getting dizzy?
He's laughing at the camera.
Yeah. He just did a breakdancing move.
Actually, he does breakdance, I swear to God. When this is all done, I'll let him show you guys how he breakdances. Talk about the new record. Are you happy with it? What's it?
It's going in a really good direction. We're using a bunch of Memphis guys, like a couple of guys playing horns, which is something new for us. And of course, you got Rick Steff on the keyboards, the B3 organ and piano, and accordion and stuff. And then we'll have Todd being on the pedal steel. So this will be the biggest.
We got backup singers.
We got backup
girl
singers.
Girl backup singer.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Woo!
That's awesome. Exactly.
Is it better?
The biggest sound?
Yeah. It's kind of. It's kind of just going another step beyond. Rebels and Rogues.
I think we wanted to make a Memphis soul record, but then even with the rock songs having horns, it's kind of turned into one of those 70s, like Atlanta rhythm section records where it's just horns and keyboards, and it's just bigger than the actual band.
So that's cool.
Yeah.
I've never been disappointed. I love every single Lucero song that I've ever heard, so I'm sure.
I think we had Ted Hutt produced it,
and
he actually came to town early and like whipped our asses into shape and actually... You know, produced, got involved.
Well, just last Friday, I was talking to the Gaslight Anthem. They were in town, and we talked about him and how you guys are using him and everything. So
that's real cool.
Yeah,
he's a great guy, and he really helped us. We had demos done, and we kind of took all the demos apart, put them back together, wrote new choruses, wrote new parts, rearranged them, and he really helped a lot with that. And it's still definitely Lucero songs, but they're just we kind of made them. I really think the best that they could be,
I know you're not completely done with it, but when do you think it'll see the light of day?
It's hopefully. Up to the label, but hopefully
the fall, September, October.
And is this like your first major label release?
Yeah, it is really.
Our first real one.
Yeah.
I'll
go ahead.
We had subsidiaries or something.
We had a distribution deal with our own through someone, but we're on Universal Republic, which is, they own us.
Which actually kind of brings up a conversation that you and I had briefly in Austin. Was just, and I don't want to get too deep here, but just fame in general. Because you were saying you don't want that. You don't want, you know what I mean? It's ruined a lot of bands, and that's not what you're going for. You just want to be able to play shows and...
Yeah, I think we're really comfortable doing what we're doing now. And growing and getting a little bit bigger isn't a bad thing at all. Right. Not always, a few more people through the door always helps. But I don't know. I don't know if I want to play. I don't want to necessarily play arenas, you know, for the rest of my life. I don't know if I'd want to get that big.
You want to play arenas?
Really? Just once. Just one arena tour. You know, you'd like it. It'd be fun.
That would be awesome.
Then we'd go back to Coliseums.
that's the difference.
I guess. I don't know.
I think theaters is fine with me.
Ah, okay.
If we can get to that level, that's just fine. We can do two nights in a row.
We always pick a level. You know, it used to be like, we can get 1 7-inch and 100 people at the shows.
Yeah, and we're actually just amazing.
If we can be like Jawbreaker and get 500 people a show, then we're done. We're making a living.
And we're doing all right.
Yeah. We are doing all right.
Now we're like, if we can just get 1,000 people.
Yeah.
And constant, you know, in Oklahoma, we're great.
It's that little taste. You always want more. I hear you. Well, you guys, I have a great show tonight. I'm excited to see it. I love your band. Thank you for sitting down with me.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Thank you very much for talking to us.
Excited about the new record, Lucero. Kevin Manno, Q101. Love you.
Cheers. Look at that. I am professional.
Yep.
That's $30,000.
Fade out to the floor.
Lucero's on stage right now. They're playing Nights Like These. This is song number 3. Having a great time. One of the best bands ever, I swear to God. I'm gonna go sing.